Hi and welcome to another week of Moments with Mike and Lois and our special guest, Mike Warnke.
Howdy.
Welcome, yeah, Mike.
Welcome.
So good to have you with us.
Oh.
And
you have no idea. I mean, how good it is for you to have me.
Oh, absolutely.
You should be. I don't know what you should be.
We are, whatever
should be
that is.
A lot.
We're doing that too.
I know where all the food is.
So we had a great weekend at yesterday recording your live comedy recording, which went amazingly well.
Thank you.
And then a great Sunday with you. Yeah. And you touched on something Saturday night and Sunday, and you talked a little bit about grace, unmerited favor. And it's, you know, we always say there's no coincidences when it comes to our lives. There are God incidences.
Absolutely.
And so it's no God incidence. The fact that God had actually been saying that through our series recently about grace, unmerited favor. And it is unmerited favor. There is nothing that we could do to earn it. We just had to accept it.
Right. Well, you know, the thing about God is, you know, there are attributes of God, and because they're attributes of God, they never change.
Right.
Because the word says there's no shadow of turning in Him. So God is always constant. Now, He's always in the now, but God is always a constant. So, you know, His love doesn't switch on and off. His salvation doesn't switch on and off. He's not happy with us one day and ticked off the next day. He's not like that. And three of the constants about God are His nature is that He is just and that He is merciful. Those two things go together.
Right.
Can't be just without mercy, and you can't be merciful without being just. But grace is a gift. And you know, God's nature is to be generous with His children.
Right.
But you have to choose to give a gift.
Yeah.
You know, if I give you a gift, I have to go, I've got to find it, I've got to wrap it, I've got to bring it to you, I've got to give it to you.
Right.
And, you know, if you have to then, you know, give me £5 for it, it's not much of a gift.
Right.
So this is the thing about God. These two things that are His nature, mercy and justice, that He is that regardless. But the fact that He has made the choice to give us the gift, that is the thing that's breathtaking to me.
Yeah.
And the fact that He paid with it with the blood of His own Son.
Right.
Now, don't tell me that somebody's willing to make that kind of payment on a gift for you, and then He's going to make it so hard for you to receive it that you never will.
Right.
And that'd be wasting the whole thing.
Right.
So yeah, unmerited favor, just grace, a gift, wrapped up in a big, pretty bow, and it's not even your birthday.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why don't you share a bit more on that?
I just think about the whole gift angle of it. You know, when you give a gift, and you know, the gift came with such a price, such an incredible price.
Yeah.
But all we have to do is receive it. Yet we find it so difficult to receive a gift that's been given so freely and paid for at such a high cost.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems too good to be true, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
This is what. Surely there's got to be some strings attached to this.
Yes.
But I can't just take it because it's been given freely. I must have to do something for it. And I think, you know, as a father, you know, as a mother, when you want to give to your children, the hardest thing is to see that they just don't want to receive that gift. What that must feel like to God when He offers His gift of grace so freely, yet His children slip it away.
I heard somebody, I can't even remember who said it, but when Satan came into the garden, what he really said to Eve is, you can't trust God.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well that's what Satan is still saying. Okay, he's got this gift, but there are strings attached. And there's a price to this gift that you're not going to want to pay.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to stay away from it. You know, give your love and give your acceptance and give your life and your commitment to other things that you can control. Because if you give yourself to God, you're going to be, and you're not going to be in control anymore. He's going to be, and you can't trust Him.
Mm.
Well, the truth is you can't trust Him. Satan's the one you can't trust.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, he's a liar and a thief. So if you really want to spend your time trusting a liar and a thief, well, okay. Yeah. But don't blame God because you get lied to and stolen from.
Right.
You can trust God. Mm. You know, He made us. He created us for a purpose. He knows all about us. Mm. He knew us before we were formed in our mother's womb. He has the number of hairs on our head counted. He has our names carved in the palm of His hand. Mm. God is not surprised by us at all. Mm. Right. He knew us from the beginning of time. So if He put this plan into purpose, knowing us all along, then we're no surprise to Him. And the fact that we're not perfect, the fact that we mess up all the time, that we can't always produce what we'd like to produce. It's like Paul said, you know, the things I want to do, I seem to never do. Yeah. And the things I don't want to do, I find myself doing all the time.
Right.
God's not surprised by that.
No.
And what He's given us is not dependent on that. But in the West, we have a production-oriented mindset. Yeah. Not so much in the Orient, but here in the West. Mm. Your value is in what you have, what you produce, blah, blah, blah. Mm. So the fact that somebody would give us something for nothing is sort of alien to our nature.
Yeah.
But that shouldn't be a surprise.
No.
Because the Bible says that God's ways are not our ways, and His thoughts are not our thoughts. So He came up with this out of His own mind, not out of my own imagination. Mm. So that's why In essence, the whole idea is rather alien to our way of thinking, but that's good.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, some great thoughts there for today. Hope that's encouraged you. And we will be back tomorrow with some more thoughts from the three of us. Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.